Okay, so today we're going to have a look at Multicouize, which is kind of a simpler version of Couise, which should be quicker to make, but maybe has a few less options. So here we go, we've got two quiz questions, and in this case, I'm telling you what the answers are. So the possible correct answers here are yes and absolutely. So if I type in yes, I get this feedback, and if I type in the correct answer there, I get another feedback, and as you can see, I also get an overall feedback. So if I do this again and do it in different order, so let's start with this one. So I would just get this feedback for this question and the other feedback for the other question and the overall feedback. And someone's gone to a lot of effort and also turned this into a crossword puzzle. So here, if I type in the right answer, this will appear. So this is kind of our feedback picture here. It is important to stress that the crossword puzzle does not come with this extension. So these are all just separate pictures of these boxes that someone's made with a lot of effort. And I would say if you want to have a crossword puzzle, I would recommend going to learning apps, and there you can make it much easier. And also you can insert it into your slide with a transparent background, so it should fit in whatever design you've got. Okay, so here I'll show you how to make it. It's not very difficult. You will need to download this template and find this blue slide. So go to the presentation where you want to use it, go to add a slide, go to my creations and find this one called Multicouize and add the blue slide. And you can see you've got here these five elements. The most important one is the question box. So if we wanted to make a new quiz, then we just need to copy all these elements over. So let's go over here. And let's say I want two questions, and I can literally just click on this and copy and paste it. Then the green box is here. This is what's going to show me my feedback. So I also need two of them. For this extension to work, you have to use them. So each one will show you a feedback picture. Then we've got these two different code boxes. They will be invisible and they will just need to be somewhere on your page. And we've got two different ones because this one here is just if you want the case to be irrelevant. So if it doesn't matter if a word is spelled with capital letter or not, then you need this box, and all you need to do is just select both these black boxes and group them for this to work. Okay, so here we've got our quiz boxes, and all we need to do is change the text that's grouped with this box. Okay, so let's say our first answer is 8 and our second answer is 10. I can just have that. But let's say my students might want to write the word as well, and I'm not sure if they're going to use the number or the word. So I can just do a straight line, which you find on the bottom right of your keyboard normally, and then put in the alternative. So 8, and then for 10, we do the same, 10. So now it will be correct if they write it as a number or as a word. Okay, then I need to find some pictures. So let's go with the classic piggy. So this is what I want to come on if they got this answer right, and the computer for the other one. Okay, so now is where it gets a bit confusing or a bit more complicated, because every time you copy and paste these green boxes, it changes the numbering. And every time you group them, it also changes the numbering. So if I go and group these two together here, you see the number disappears, and now I need to get out of the slide, so go to any other slide, and then come back again for the numbering to reset. So it's still on 2, which is good, and group this. I go out, back in, but now, because this was the first one I grouped and this one the second one I grouped, it now means this has turned into number 1 and this has turned into number 2. And so I need to swap them around, because on 1 will always go with question 1 and on 2 will go with question 2. And you can see that the question boxes have also updated. So question 1, question 2. So if I copy and paste another one, so at first it's empty, but if I go out and back in again, now you can see this is question 3. So make sure that you constantly update your numbering so you know what is what. And let's say you change your plan and you don't want the computer anymore and you ungroup this. Now, if I go back out and in again, it then messes with the numbering again. So if I group this, because now it's the second item I've grouped, because the pick was still grouped, now this has turned into two again. So just the best way of doing it really is to avoid grouping and ungrouping and just decide at the beginning which picture you want with which answer. Have all your pictures ready and then group them in the right order. So group the first one with the first picture, the second one with the second picture, and so on, so that you don't mess up your order. Okay, so, and to check, always go out and back in again. So now we also want global on. So let's say we want these guys to appear if we got everything right. I've got them twice now, but it doesn't really matter. So let's group this together, these two. Group, okay, let's see if this works. So you can see here that this box down here is still visible and it still says Q1 and Q2. Don't worry about that. It's only because you're in preview mode. So they will be invisible as soon as you go into presentation mode. Okay, so also it still shows me the answer, which obviously we don't really want. So here, 8. Okay, because this is on 1, it shows this one first because this is my first question and my first feedback. And then here I can put in 10 and it now shows me the second feedback and the overall feedback as well. For this one, well, A, it's not safe that I had written 10 here. And that seems to be a problem with Genially, I found that if you write something and then don't go into another text box or click on another element, it often doesn't save it properly, which is a bit annoying. Just like some of the other extensions, this extension offers you the option to create your own quiz box. So the question box here where you put in the answer, so you can change the color of it and the font of it to make it fit more into the theme that you're going for. So for that you need this yellow template and you need to use it in preview mode. So let's go in there, and there are lots of different options I can change, and at the moment you can see here what it looks like. So quite small. So maybe I want to make it a bit bigger, I want to make it a bit longer because my answer is quite long. I can change the size of the border and I can make the background transparent. I can even change this type of border and so on. So lots of different options I've got here. And I can change the name of the font as well. It doesn't need to be one of those. It can be any of the ones that are offered in Genially, but the font needs to be used in text that is on that page. So for example, in the instructions or in the title. So I'm going for School Bell, which I know is one of the fonts. Okay, and now I've got this text box here, this script box. So I just copy the script. And then if I go onto my quiz page, so let's go in here. So I need to remember, I need to use that writing somewhere. So let's turn this into School Bell, which I want to use. Okay, so now I can go to Insert, Other, and this is where I paste that iframe code. And I go to Insert, and now I've got that box I made, and you can see that this is the one that has the red border, and hopefully it will also have the right font. So now if I write in here, hello, yes, you can just about see that it is using the School Bell font up there. It's maybe a bit small, so I could change it again to make it a bit bigger.